why is it that so many people have to take drugs and in bodybuilding? I mean,
they don't have to. Nobody puts a gun to their head.
That's true.
We do have volition. We have free will.
Why is it so many people?
It's their value system.
Yeah.
They haven't learned to think. Well, actually, I'm not so sure necessarily that drugs are bad for people. I'm not against the advancements of medical science. If I were convinced that steroids were so terribly bad, I wouldn't have taken them myself. They can be bad without a doubt, just like aspirin can be bad.
Right.
People have a very difficult time thinking about this issue because of the hysteria, the public hysteria going on about steroids, especially in the press.
Mm-hmm.
There's no doubt that there have been abuses of steroids, and steroids, like any other drug, can be abused and lead to bad physical results. But yeah, most bodybuilders think that they have to take them, and once they decide to, they don't give it much thought. They take them indiscriminately, using, again, the almost childlike notion, more jelly beans are better than less, then why not take more steroids?
Right.
More is better. Why not do more sets? Train 2 to 4 hours a day. Train twice a day. Train 6 or 7 days a week. Take all the steroids you can possibly financially afford. You see how childlike an approach to life this is?
Right.
There are more principles guiding human life than the idea that more is better. That is an ethical economic principle, as I pointed out in the first tape. You can't achieve success in a different context or another context without studying that context in and of itself and deriving principles therefrom, principles that will serve as guidelines for effective or successful human action. You can't take principles from one context and apply them blindly and uncritically in another one and expect to achieve any results at all necessarily.
Mm-hmm.
That's a very childlike approach to life. You have that one idea embedded in your subconscious from childhood, more is better. Then you apply it blindly to everything you encounter in life. Life ain't super complicated once you understand how to use basic principles, once you understand how to think. But unless you get there, it becomes impossibly difficult because you're never going to succeed. It does require a certain amount of mental effort, of course, over a period of time to understand the principles of thought, the laws of logic, but it's not infinitely complex. Anybody with a normal, intact, functioning brain can read Aristotle or Ayn Rand and learn the law of identity, the law of causality, and how to use logic.
Mike, what about, we mentioned steroids, just your opinion about the legality of them and whatnot. We've got people like Dan Duchesne, who's a real character, and he just doesn't see any need for these drugs to be illegal, and now they're controlled substances and whatnot, and you literally could go to any pro bodybuilding contest and pick these guys off the stage and arrest them for internal possession of a controlled substance or suspicion of internal possession of a controlled substance, because
right.
You literally can't look like a pro bodybuilder without using steroids, in my opinion, and I don't know anyone who's done it.
No, you can't. I tell those who ask me about steroids, I say, look, it's debatable possibly whether or not there's a health issue here, whether or not steroids pose a real strong risk to your physical well-being. What cannot be debated is that there is a legal risk.
Yeah.
Now, what's the purpose of all goal achievement ultimately is to achieve happiness, self-esteem, confidence, inner serenity. If you're walking around all day long, Bill, with a knot of anxiety in your gut, fearful that you're being watched by the feds, then you're achieving the opposite of the desired result. Big muscles are important, people, but it's a reality that there is a real legal risk here. Now, I have some reason to understand that the feds have lessened or diminished their march on this thing. But they're still out there. I'm not so sure it's worth it. Why not try training? Why not try training naturally for a while?
Well, I'll tell you, that's the thing that I really try to get across to the people that I know and the people that read the magazine is, it is debatable, in my opinion, as to what the risks are for the proper use of anabolic steroids in normally healthy people. But it is not debatable in any way, shape, or form that if you get busted with these things, you're going to be miserable.
Without a doubt.
And I know dozens, not just one or two, but I know dozens of bodybuilders who have gone to jail or who are in jail for being involved in anabolic steroids. And
I see it even now. I, of course, working in Gold's Gym, I see and hear all manner of things. I hear bodybuilders talking about buying and selling drugs all the time as if they had never heard of these other guys getting busted. Some of these guys are actually quite innocent, decent people.
Absolutely.
They have decided that taking drugs does not pose a serious enough health threat to deter them from taking them.
Right.
So they decided to do it. But they continue to overlook the legal risk. And sometimes I have to giggle and kind of marvel at their innocence and ignorance. These feds aren't joking.
Yeah.
They will put you in jail. It's not just a threat.
Yeah.
As Bill Phillips just said to your listener, dozens of people have been put in jail.